King Lot. Tonight, see Larry battle profusely off at Howard Stern fan phone calls. Now, here's Larry King.
Hey, I've made it. I don't have to be neurotic anymore. I'm on network television. I'm a star. We're ready to go to your phone calls on this extraordinarily important topic. We go to Cinnaminson, New Jersey. Hello.
Yes, good morning, Larry.
Hi.
I would like to ask Mr. Fredrickson what his opinion is of Howard Stern.
Why?
I don't know. Who's Howard Stern?
He doesn't know who he is, sir. Lars,
I'm sorry.
He's a radio.
No, he does a radio show in New York.
In New York.
Reading, Pennsylvania for Reuben Greenberg. Hello.
Yes, I would like to ask Mr. Greenberg if Mr. Trump was right about Larry's bad breath.
No, he was wrong. Mr. Trump was kidding. A man is living alone, needs a gun.
Philadelphia, hello.
Yes, good morning, Larry.
Hi.
Howard Stern.
Cinnaminson, New Jersey. Hello.
Howard Stern.
Okay, hello.
Yes, good morning, Larry.
Hi.
Howard Stern.
Okay, Kerrville, Texas. Hello.
Howard Stern. Howard Stern. Howard Stern. Howard Stern. Howard Stern.
You are the one that's negative. I'm trying to make you positive, and you're giving me that you had this from the womb. Sort of looking for a little tabloid sensationalism, is because we don't do that. Hey, I've made it. I don't have to be neurotic anymore. I'm on network television. I'm a star. I'm a star. I'm a star. I'm a star. I'm a star.
Yes, who?
Hello, is this John DeBella?
Yeah.
How's it feel to be a loser?
Listen, you know, not as good as it does when your mother blows me.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, you can't come back, can you?
Eat
asshole.
Me. Eat me.
Yes, I'm the one who called a little while ago, and you said to call back 10:30.
Morning, Zoo.
Yes, may I speak with John DeBella, please?
Can I ask your phone?
My name's Bill. I do a newspaper for the Gwinnett Mercy College.
Okay, Bill, hold on one second.
Thank
Can
you.
I ask what the call's about?
Yes, this morning I'd called up John to ask him for an interview, and he made a really rude comment to me over the phone.
Okay, hold on one second.
I'd just like to ask him.
Sure, hold on a second. Thanks.
I called you up this morning to do an article. I do an article for the Gwinnett Mercy College.
Uh-huh.
And you said a really rude comment to me, and I just wanted...
No, let's put a couple of things straight, okay? First off, if you want to do an interview, you call my office and you request one. You do not call me while I'm on the air and start your interview. Secondly, it is illegal to tape record someone without them knowing about it.
I didn't tape
record
you.
Oh, well, wait a second. What did you tell to my receptionist earlier today? Be careful.
Listen, I just wanted to know why you said that.
Why I said that is because I have, Bill, what do you think? You're the only person who calls me?
No, but
a large amount of crank callers.
But you made a comment about my mother, and I didn't
fine,
expect
well, fine.
It.
How did you start, what was the first thing you said to me?
I asked you how it felt to be a loser.
Well, are you doing an interview there, or are you making a comment?
Well, I just wanted to get, like, kind of
Are you doing an interview there, or are you making a comment?
More or less an interview.
An interview? It seems that you've already made a decision.
Now, see, I just wanted to get your first reaction, because I haven't heard you comment about it on the air.
Well, you got it.
I've been listening to the Zoo.
YSP.
Hello, this is God. I have a request.
Oh, my God. I guess I better play it, huh?
Oh, my what?
Oh, sorry. Just lost my head there. What do you want to hear, God? What, man? Let's get right back. CJ, you're up.
Hello, Dr. Corey.
How are you?
I'm just fine. My question is there any side effects, if any, of sleeping with an animal?
Sleeping with an animal?
Yes.
Are you talking about... I mean...
This is not funny.
No, but I mean, what are you talking about? A dog, cat, what?
A dog.
A dog. You talk about sleeping with... No, there's no side effects sleeping with a dog, not unless you got the dog right on top of you.
Side of the speakers.
And I'm over here now on the right.
Yeah.
See how that works?
But we'll flip over just so we won't confuse you.
Oh, boy. Yeah. Oh, you guys are both very amazing. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Captain. We really appreciate the call. When you next speak to Howard, you pass on our regards, okay?
Yes, I'll do that.
Thank you very much.
See you clear. Have a nice day, boys.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Let's go to Pennsylvania. We have another caller waiting. Sue has called us. Sue, go ahead.
Hello.
Good morning. We can hear you.
Good morning. God bless you and your program,
Thank you, sir. Sue.
What is your opinion of Howard Stern?
Tell us a little bit about Howard Stern, Sue.
Excuse me?
I said, tell us a little bit about Howard Stern. He's not somebody that...
He's a radio broadcaster on WXRK in New York, WYSP in Philadelphia, and WJFK in Washington.
Okay. You're talking about... somebody that does a radio call-in and things like that?
Yes.
I'm not familiar with him, so I can't offer an opinion. But can you elaborate on us for our large audience? Is this somebody that's controversial?
Yes. I would like to know how you feel about his broadcast and generally himself.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Sue, since I don't know the individual, I can't express an opinion. I know there are individuals who do talk radio who sometimes stimulate the juices and get people into controversy.
I see.
One of the things that we've tried to do on this program, and we've succeeded, I think, over a period of almost 3 years, is to rather than alienate individuals as we interact with them, we try to work in a reconciliatory way and provide... healing for the hurt that people do have. So, you know, if we've touched you or anybody
me,
in
sir.
That way, then we hope that we've been successful.
Excuse me, sir?
Yes, Sue.
You guys are nuts. I'm scamming you.
Okay. Well, she's got a reason
I'm,
for calling.
Absolutely.
And I'm sure that when Sue thinks about it, that, you know, every kind of person that makes up our larger community has a place in it. And one of the things that we try to do is to provide that healing. Mm-hmm. And I think your presence here and others who have called in and touched one another with their healing, that's what this program is all about.
Jank, Sandy Bloom calling. Sorry, man, I forgot to get back to you earlier today. I just spaced out. Heard the rock climb thing, pretty funny, and heard you with Howard this morning and all that sort of stuff. I'm having a party over at my place Saturday about 4, mostly. I just wanted to invite you. Figure at this point you ought to be hanging out with us, you know? Give me a call at the station tomorrow if you can make it, 4 o'clock Saturday. Beer and brat. If you're not from Milwaukee, you don't know what a brat is. It's a bratwurst. It's kind of like a sausage is the concept. So it'll be fun. Give me a buzz at the station tomorrow. I'll give you directions and all that kind of shit, all right? Later, man.
Hello?
Steve.
Yes.
Hey, how you doing?
Hi.
The guy who called. I called you tonight.
Yeah, on the air, you mean?
Yeah. Listen, I was wondering, when's the next time you're going to be out in New York?
I have no idea. Hang on one second.
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, when's the next time you're going to be out in New York?
I have no idea.
You think you'll ever stop by, like, the Howard Stern show?
Probably not, no.
You don't like Howard Stern?
No, I've never heard Howard Stern.
He's marketed in Philadelphia, New York, and Washington.
Yeah. I have to go because I got people waiting for me. So.
You don't think you'd ever come out there, though?
I'm sorry. You have to talk to my agent. I have no idea. So.
Hey, he's like in 3 markets, and he has 3 million listeners.
Yeah, I know who he is. Yeah. Anyway, I've got to go. Here's the...
Hold on, please.
Thanks.
I am sorry, but Steve had to leave.
Okay, thanks.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's go to North Wales and Bill. Hi, Bill. How are you?
Hello, Frank.
Hi.
And hello, Mary.
Hello, Bill.
Yes, my question deals with, I'm in my car right now. I'm headed down towards a restaurant. I'm trying to find a nice Cajun restaurant to go to around the area.
Okay. A good Cajun...
In an accident?
Are you all right?
Bill?
Bill?
Oh, dear, that sounded terrible.
Oh, boy. We'll hope that he calls back, all right?
Yes.
I'm sure he's all right. I got my fingers crossed.
Oh,
that was
dear,
a little
that
bit scary.
Okay. Scary.
Let's go to Irene in Warrington. Hi, Irene.
Andrew, nice one. Thanks. Let's talk to Tom in Philadelphia. 94WYSP is our station there. Tom, you're on the Rock Line.
Yes, first I'd like to congratulate all the nominees sitting here in the studio on your nominees for the Grammys.
Thank you.
And I'd like to ask all of you your opinion of Howard Stern, the radio personality on WXRK in New York.
Well, I've never had to come across him personally. I've never had to interview him. I've watched him. Do you know?
I met him a couple of times, and I certainly have heard about him.
Yeah.
He's a vegetarian, I hear, which is really
interesting. Because he eats meat at his show 4 hours
a day.
Yeah,
exactly.
there's shows like that.
I live in California, so personally, I'm not that familiar with the style other than what I hear, and I don't like to comment on stuff I don't know about.
There you go, Tom. Florida concert dates with Whitesnake, 25th in Tampa and Fort Myers on the 27th. We have a call from Seattle right now. It's Bill, a listener of Rock 106 in Spokane. It's actually where he's located. Hi, Bill.
Hi. First of all, I'm sorry about the interference. I'm on a car phone. But I'm a really big fan of you guys. I love you guys. I always will love you guys to the day I die. May I say that much first?
Well, why not?
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Bill.
Oh, my God.
That's not too good for a carpool, yeah. Bill.
I like that, though.
Low sample.
Yeah, I like that.
That's great. One fan down. Nick, that's it. He's gone for the night, huh? Good. Does he have a question, do you think? Yeah, Bill, do you have a question?
Yes.
All right.
what are your opinions of Howard Stern, the radio personality?
Uh-oh. He's a lovely, lovely, lovely man.
A wonderful man, and thanks for your call. You're better off with your comedy, Bill. Thanks. You got a call from Rob?
Let's go back to the callers now. There's something on this screen. I can't read the first name from Lansdale.
Yes, this is
BJ.
Peter.
Yes, hi.
Yes, I believe that if a man breaks into your house, that someone has every right to fire a weapon at him. I have a weapon, and I am not afraid to use it. Listen.
Hey, that's great. That's wonderful. That's terrific. Now, put it in your mouth and do it again.
So they enforce the coverage.
There have been many cases where there's been no reaction to the community that it didn't even make page six. So that is not true.
Let's take a phone call. Let me take a phone call. Yes, you're on the air.
Hello?
Hi, go ahead.
Yes, Reverend Al Sharpton?
Yes.
Yes, what is your opinion of Howard Stern, radio personality?
You know what? Can I do this? Let's cut this phone call off. Has nothing to do with our subject today.
Back to the phones we go, and Dale, you're up.
Hey, how you doing, Dr. James?
Yeah, I'm fine, buddy. How you doing tonight?
All right, I'm going by an article that brought this topic about that I'm thinking of that I found in the Philadelphia Magazine, and it's it looks like Jill Feldman wrote it.
Right.
The article is entitled DiBella in Decline, and then it goes on to say, for 5 years, John DiBella called in the tune of Philadelphia Morning Radio. Now that he's number two, can he face the music? And then it goes on to say,
I didn't get the new issue of Philadelphia Magazine as of yet.
Oh yes, it's really a very interesting article. Then it goes on to say, John DiBella realized how scared he was at the end of the line about a week after he lost his first ratings race to Howard Stern, the disc jockey whose show has been piped in from New York on WYSP since 1986. DiBella was playing a commercial on his own morning zoo program on WMMR from his 5 years highest rated show in Philadelphia Rock and Roll Radio when he took a call on the request line. Strange voice, but not the one that didn't shock the man who's...
Are you talking about you're the guy that calls all the radio stations?
No, that's not me, no.
It certainly sounds like you.
I'm referring to this.
Oh, you are?
No, I was wondering, because you sound an awful lot like that guy.
What are you talking about?
There's a guy that has a tendency to call a lot of radio stations.
Yeah.
And he talks a lot about this kid, Howard Stern. That's not you?
Not me, no.
Okay, because your voice, you sound very similar. But go ahead.
Okay. It goes on to say... Even in decline, DeBell remained sure of himself. I've been in Philadelphia for 8 years, and in that time, I've never been told to do anything, he says. I've only been...
What's the point you're trying to make? That Stern's kicking his butt?
No, I'm trying to read the article to you.
Yeah, but they send me Philadelphia Magazine.
What kind of ratings do you have, anyway?
Very fine. Number one in the city.
Did you ever have a morning show?
No, I've never been on a morning. You want to put me up against Stern?
No, not at all. I enjoy your show very much.
Okay, good. You know, that's the funny thing about Howard Stern. He sounds just like Alan Alda.
Oh.
You buy that?
Maybe a little bit, yeah.
He sounds exactly like him.
But now he has a...
He reminds me of a wuss.
DeBell has a 6.8 and Stern has an 8.9 in the latest Arbitron report. And it's being suggested all over town that DeBell had better get the feel of being number two.
I understand what you say, but I think you're the kind of a guy that calls a lot of radio stations. You'd like to talk about Howard Stern. I think you're like a Howard Stern plant guy. Look, we know who Howard Stern is. Howard Stern does a pretty good job. You got to understand that he's the kind of a kid that a lot of people listen to. They really and truly do. And I think that there are a lot of radio stations in Philadelphia, namely WWDB, that should give this kid a pretty good run after you find out that they die out to some extent. The kid's never lasted very long in whatever market he's been in. But it'll be very interesting to see what goes down with Stern in this market. Let's go right back to the phones, and Pete, you're up.
Whew. We're back with Harry Gross, and I know some of you people have been waiting a long time to get on and speak to Harry, so we're going to do that right now and start picking up some phone calls. Dale in Ballack-Kinwood, you're on WWDB.
Hey, Harry, what is your opinion of Howard Stern? Let him answer you, dumb stew.
I have no idea. Okay, I think that was some kind of a joke. We'll go to another caller. Harry looks mystified. There's someone out there who understands that Howard Stern and I, he's on WISP in the morning, broadcasting from New York, he and I have been having a feud for the better part of 2 years.
Is he the one with the filthy mouth?
That's the one, and the one with the no brain. So anyway, that obviously was some Stern jackass trying to interfere with this very... No, jackass is okay to say. Okay, we'll go ahead and now ask for Bob in West Philadelphia. You're on WWDB.
Philadelphia, hello.
Yes, hello there. This is Captain John.
Yeah.
Okay, first I'd like to apologize because I started this off as a novel joke and it seems to be blown out of proportion like I just heard a little while ago.
What are you talking about?
Someone just called, the other night I saw three people called your show and talked about Howard, and I just think that
actually, when people call and mention Howard Stern out of this show or television, what they're doing is hurting Howard. They don't bother me, I just fling along into the night.
Hey, John! It's your buddy, Bloom! Surprise! Listen, you no-talent bald fuck! Eat me!
Tom, you're live on WCAU.
Hello, Mary. I'm on my car phone. I'm just listening to the show. I love your show. I always have loved your show. And I will love your show till the day I die.
Well, Tom, I tell you, I thank you for that.
Thank you. My question is that oh, my God.
Oh, my God. I hope you're not joking me. You know, with what happened on Friday, I'm not sure if that's a joke or not. Is he off? Well, I'm not going to get too taken aback by it because they have things like that on, you know, they have recordings like that, don't you? And with what happened on Friday, I hope that that's okay. You know, it's a cruel joke to play on somebody. Because the man said, I'm going to like your show until the day I die, and then suddenly we get this accident-sounding situation. I'm going to tell you something. It's not going to bother me. I'm just not going to be taken by it. I'm really not going to be taken. What was his name? Well, the name that he gave us. Tom. Okay, we'll see what happens.
Yes, who?
John?
Yes?
Would you be interested in licking my ass crack?
No. I don't want to do that at all. And, you know, I really don't like talking to you because, you know, you always have that tape recorder running.
I don't run no tape recorder. You listen to Howard Stern Show, don't you?
Yeah.
And you've never heard of Captain Jinks?
No.
Oh, boy. Oh, dear. This is terrible.
We get the unexpurgated version down in California.
The unexpurgated version? Oh, of Howard?
Yeah.
Oh, you're in California right now?
Yeah.
Oh, I say.
Yeah, absolutely.
What do you mean the unexpurgated version?
The version that people in New York aren't allowed to hear. Where are you?
Oh, I'm in Pennsylvania, Philadelphia.
Oh, okay, that's a good town to be from.
How can you be from California if this call is 212?
Because it just passed through to me.
Oh, I see. Yes, you have a very good show, you know that?
Thank you very much. I would say you have extremely good taste. If you listen to Howard Stern, you watch My Generation, I would say that would be on par to none.
Well, of course, yeah, well, I've heard you a couple times on...
Yeah, I love doing Howard Stern. I might do it tomorrow morning, actually. You going to listen tomorrow?
Oh, yes, I listen every day, yes.
Okay, well, you might hear me there tomorrow.
Oh, well, you could tell Howard that you spoke with myself, and he'll know who I am.
Oh, really?
Yes, Jessica Hahn was at the sports night here in town last night, and we went down there, and Jessica will probably be calling in tomorrow also.
Ah, right.
But that's pretty strange that while you'd be sitting around taking phone calls.
I know, I do like to do stuff like this because I want to know who watches this show.
Oh, well, isn't it like the one of the highest rated shows on VH1?
I would say it's by at least double any other show on VH1.
You know Meg Griffith.
That's why they pay me the big bucks.
You know Meg Griffith, don't you?
No.
Well, she's a DJ on K-Rock, but I was aware that she used to be on VH1.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Meg Griffin?
I don't know who she is.
Oh, boy. I am very good friends with the publisher of the Howard Stern Show newsletter.
Uh-huh.
And if you'd like, I can have one faxed to you weekly. It's free.
Oh, I'd love to. Here's my fax number, 805.
Let me get a pen and write this down. Because I think the it's kind of like updates on what Howard's doing, and it has pictures in it, and I'm sure, and you've been in it before, I'm pretty sure, because you called in one of Howard's shows.
On Detroit, it's about 3 months.
Yes, I remember that. That was about 2 months ago.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
805.
805.
9-5.
5-1. Okay, I'll let him know, and you'll receive one on a weekly basis if you'd like. This you'll definitely get this.
Fab Gear and Wunderbar.
Yes, and it's the Howard Stern Show newsletter, and it'll give you an update of what's what happened on Howard's show that week.
That would be great.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Listen, it was very nice talking to you.
Nice meeting you, Kurt.
Captain Jinks.
Well, I beg your pardon?
It's Kurt. Yes. You okay?
Okay, Captain.
Okay, I'll see you later.
Bye.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
John?
Yes.
Yes, how do you feel about Howard's 10.3?
Doesn't really matter to me, to tell you the truth.
Yeah. Well, I heard some comments that you made on the air today.
No, I didn't make any comments. Well, tell me what comments.
About throwing up and vomit.
No, actually, I didn't make those comments. So there's your first mistake. You want to continue?
Well, who made those comments?
The comedian we had on the show this morning.
Well, don't you scream the comedians?
No.
I don't believe this.
No? There's what's so hard to believe about that?
It's just outrageous. I don't see... I turn to the station next to you on Howard Stern, he's talking about penises. And I turn on your station, and they're talking about drowning in vomit.
Okay, now hold on one moment.
That's disgusting, sir.
Hold on one moment. Okay? First off, before... what I would do, if you want to continue the conversation, is calm down. All right? Because probably if you pick up the phone and try to even attempt this conversation with Howard Stern, he wouldn't even answer.
And why's that?
Why's that? Because he doesn't speak to the public. He doesn't give a damn. All right? Now, I'm taking time out of my day to talk to you. I have a lot of work to do, and I am more than willing to hear what it is that's bothering you.
So
to tell you the truth, right, the fact that Jimi Hendrix, which I guess you missed, died because he died in a pool of vomit, and the comment afterwards was, it must take a lot of vomit to fill a pool, and that was the extent of it. It wasn't a conversation. It was a comment that a comic made on the show, and no, I do not believe in censoring people. That is why I'm on a campaign in this state to stop the record labeling bill. I'm not going to censor a comedian, and then on the other hand, try to stop somebody from censoring music.
I see.
All right.
Go on.
Go on. What's going on with the telephone?
Excuse me?
What's going on with the telephone?
What are you talking about?
Well, someone obviously picked up the telephone or did something with the telephone as I was speaking.
Is that your stance, sir?
Now, can I find out who you are? I don't know who you are. I don't even know why I'm talking to you. I don't understand why in God's name someone talking about vomit should upset you so much.
Drowning in vomit, dying in vomit.
Dying in vomit, dying in vomit, whatever the case. And there go the clicks on the phone again. Now, who are you? Do you have a name?
I don't understand.
You're on the air.
With Howard Stern. He wouldn't even answer.
So why's that?
Why's that? Because he doesn't speak to the public. He doesn't give a damn.
John DeBell realized how scared he was at the end of the line about a week after he lost his first ratings race to Howard Stern, the disc jockey whose show has been piped in from New York on WYSP since 1986.
Hello,
is this John DeBell?
Yeah.
How's it feel to be a loser?
Let's put a couple of things straight, okay? First off, if you want to do an interview, you call my office and you request one. You do not call me.
What is this?
On the
I don't know. Somebody's playing as a program.
Start your interview.
This is a zookeeper.
It is illegal to tape record someone without them knowing about it. Be careful.
Now, who are you? Do you have a name?
Yes, I do.
Hello, is this John DeBell?
Yeah.
How's it feel to be a loser? Loser, 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 loser.
Listen, you know, not as good as it does when your mother.
Hello? Pretty cool. Nice little montage.
Jeez.
We're going to talk with Tom now in Philadelphia. 94 WYSP is our affiliate there. And Tom, you're on the rock line.
Hi, Bruce.
Hey, Tom.
Hi.
How's it going?
What is your opinion of Howard Stern and is Andy Blum gay?
I warned you, Bruce. I got a whole payroll out there, and yeah. I have no idea why.
Howard Stern, he's got a lot of representatives going.
Apparently so, yeah.
I got to say, I'm not all that up on Howard Stern, Tom.
Would you ever go on his show?
I don't really know a whole lot about him.
Would you ever go on his show?
I'm not the right guy to answer your question, Tom.
Thanks so much for being on the phone with us, Tom.
With John Densmore, formerly of The Doors, the book Riders on the Storm, Quakertown, Pennsylvania. Hello.
Is it true like my father was written about Howard Stern, John?
No, it's not true. I'm going to bust that myth. Sorry.
St. Petersburg to Depression. St. Petersburg, Florida. Hello.
We're talking to Dave now as we head to Philadelphia. 94 WYSP is our station there, and Dave, you're on with us. Good evening.
Dave.
Hi.
How you doing?
All right. Is it true that in the song Teach Your Children, pedal steel guitar was played by Howard Stern?
No. Yes, he was.
No.
Hey, I wrote the song. I know who played pedal steel on Teach Your Children. It was Howard Stern.
Howard Stern.
No, it wasn't Howard Stern. Howard Stern. No, Howard Stern. No. Howard Stern. What awful thing can we say about Howard? We could say something. This is our chance. Let's see. Howard brought the acid to the session. That was the deal.
Yeah. It was Jerry Garcia.
It was Jerry Garcia.
Those little Bart Simpson stamps, right? Thanks for the call there, Dave.
9:45, 15 from 10. I'm Mr. Morning. Tom, did you watch the Monday Night Football game last night?
Hello?
Hello, Tom.
Yeah.
Did you watch it, Tom?
Hello? I'm here.
Hello, Tom.
You!
Tom, I'm sorry I called you an idiot.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Okay, man. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Philadelphia. Hey, Don?
Yeah,
how's it feel to be a loser? Howard Stern rules. You suck.
Oh, thank you very much, sir.
Eat me. How you like that?
We've got a caller out there. Caller, what is your name and where are you calling from? And what's your reaction to what Dinkins just told us?
I'm calling from West Orange. Curtis, what's your opinion of Howard Stern?
Oh. I'd like to give that guy a good five-knuckle sandwich, but that's not what we're talking about. You had an opinion, sir.
And we have Dave from Pennsylvania. Dave?
Hello, gentlemen.
Hi.
May I say fuck you?
Well, I don't know. I guess he was able to do it. How about Gene from Florida?
Next caller, 15 minutes left to go, is from Florida.
What is your opinion of Howard Stern?
All right, thank you for the call. Every once in a while, we get an unexpected one.
Well, it's a problem to have a call
from Usually, Congressman, do you have a problem every now and then with people still calling you Gopher?
No, I don't have a problem. They do that all the time.
What is your opinion of Howard Stern?
I'm sorry, what is that?
We just lost that call. We shouldn't mention that. I didn't mention that in your bio, but I know you were involved in theater at Harvard University, and you did something else after that, connected with theater television?
Yeah.
What was that again?
It was the Love Boat.
Ah, yes.
As if you didn't know.
We are not here to talk about that, however, here to talk about congressional matters.
Jenks, it's Andy Blum. Give me a call at the station whenever you get in, okay? Thanks, man. Bye.
Okay, let's go to the phones up to Haverford, Connecticut. You're on the air. Go right ahead.
Hello, Representative Hastert. Do you have a big dick?
I'm moving right along.
Congressman James Oberstar, guest. Let's go right to the phones. Westchester, Pennsylvania, you're first. Good morning.
Good morning, Connie. My question for Representative Oberstar is if he feels that you shave your snatch.
Congressman, let me go ahead.
I didn't understand what he said.
Hello, you have reached the machine of Floyd Zavino. After the beep, please leave a message, your name and a number, and he'll surely get back to you. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Yes, hello, this is Captain Jenks from the 36th Field Artillery in the Federal Republic of Germany. You can normally hear me on the Howard Stern Show. I'm calling you in reference to perhaps coming on your show. You can reach me at 699-42 in the 215 area code. Thank you.
Philadelphia. Oh, I'm sorry. Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, hometown.
That's
hello.
Cosby.
Hi, Mr. Cosby. Have
yes,
you heard
sir.
About Howard Stern, the radio personality?
Oh,
Harry, let him answer now.
I'm letting him answer. He can answer. Howard Stern is one of those people who lives off of doing those things that I consider to be at times very, very cheap shots. But there's an audience there, and those people seem to like what he does. So I don't listen to him.
You don't? Have you ever gone on a show?
I went on a long time ago. But what is the fellow... I want to know what the caller is...
What is your purpose, sir?
Excuse me?
What is the purpose of the call?
Oh, this is Captain Jenks, Larry. I'm just calling to inquire Bill Cosby's opinion on Howard Stern.
Why aren't you involved in your own self? Why would you be so involved in Mr. Stern's life?
Well, let's put it this way, Larry. I'd like to...
Let's say goodnight.
Howard, this is Fred. Ain't no fun one no more. A record for messers. I got good news for you. And the good news is I got a phone call from Channel 9 TV. If they want me to be part of the House Star Summer Special Show, I'm going to be on TV, coast to coast, border to border. And another good thing is, they said they don't know what my part will be on the show, but they didn't mention the name of Jessica Hahn. I know you say, call me up tonight and I'll tell you more about it. Okay, Tom, take care, bye.
Yes, who?
John, do loose lips sink ships?
I give up, do they?
I don't know, that's what you said.
Okay. Yes, who?
Loser, loser. Philadelphia Magazine about you? About WMMR?
About John?
Yeah, did you see that?
Yes, I did.
What the hell's that all about?
Well, they wanted to write an article, so they wrote one.
Yeah, but I mean, it was a bad article, you know?
I know. It was very vicious, wasn't it?
It was only about our greatest radio station around here.
Well, I feel bad about it. I know John feels bad about it, but, you know, when the print press is out to get you, they'll get you.
Well, what the hell are they after him for? He didn't do nothing.
Well,
all he's done is give us good radio for the past 5 years.
I know, I agree, but the print press in Philadelphia has always disliked John, and any chance they get to jump on his ass, they will.
Oh, man.
If,
he ain't really going crazy like this in the article, is he?
No, I mean, anybody is in his position is under pressure, you know. I mean, but we allowed this reporter to come up here and observe, and...
Jeez,
you know, every morning is a pressure kind of situation, and they just interpreted it as, you know, as how they interpreted it. It's just through their ignorance, that's all.
Oh, well. Can you play a tune for me anyway?
What's that?
Think you'd be able to?
What's the song?
Well, okay, well, it's been quite a while since I heard anything from the Talking Heads. I heard you play Psycho Killer yesterday, but I'm in the mood for something different.
I'll put it on the list, my friend. What's your name?
My name's Bill.
Bill, where are you calling from?
North Wales.
Why, thanks. If you have a chance to write a letter to Philadelphia Magazine, please do.
Oh, otherwise... yeah, I've already done that.
Cool.
I've already sent a letter over to them about, you know, how much I thought that they didn't give anybody a fair chance. I don't even think they... It didn't even seem to me like they talked to John, because that didn't sound like him at all.
Well, you know, anybody can say something, and then if it's taken out of context, like the print press always does, it sounds pretty bad, you know? I mean... You say a lot of things under your breath, you know?
Yeah, and you think that's might have been what he... Well, the hell?
You know, I mean...
I'm sure he's angry anyway. I mean,
pardon my French, but it's a natural thing to say, oh, fuck this or fuck that, you know? And then they pick it up and make a big deal out of it.
Yeah, exactly.
You know? So, well, that's show business.
Yes, it is.
Thanks for listening, Bill.
All right, thank you.
Take care, bro.
Bye.
Captain?
Yes, hello.
Hello.
Yes, you know, I just saw... Is this Flo?
Yes.
I just saw a video of the Turtles on VH1.
Oh, which one?
It was Happy Together.
Oh, yeah?
Where all of you were running around, and I believe there was one part in there where you were all, like, in the water or something like that.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that was a very good video. And also, a couple who's getting married next week, a private who's in my battery.
Uh-huh.
He's getting married, and I'm very serious when I say this, to a turtle song.
Are you kidding?
I swear, it's going to be their first dance at the reception.
Which song?
I don't remember what he said, but I probably have it, but I don't remember what he
showed
said.
Me.
And I thought that was really cool, and I thought I'd let you guys know that even now, and this is going on 20 years later, people are still using your songs as their wedding song.
Isn't that great? Well, why don't you remind me next week on a certain day, and we'll give them a good luck.
Yeah, so cool.
All right.
Okay, well, how I understand both of you both came back from going on tour?
Yes.
How was that?
Oh, it went great.
You were playing live?
Yes, as a matter of fact, we played in Great Adventure one day.
Oh, yes, I remember that. I couldn't get down there. I was out on duty that day.
Uh-huh.
I felt kind of bad about it, but because I would like to come down and see what you guys do these
bottom
days.
Bottom line, we're at the bottom line all through New Year's.
Are you doing old Turtle stuff and new stuff in the old fluorescent?
We do kind of a potpourri of our whole career.
Ooh, good. You're going to watch myself on the Uncle Foley tour, aren't you?
When is that?
Well, myself and Fred the Elephant Boy, Shelly the Typist, and Kevin from the Newsletter are going to be on Uncle Floyd show on Thursday. Howard talked about it today.
Oh, I didn't. See, I don't know if I get Uncle Floyd on my cable hookup.
Okay, oh, boy.
All right, wait, I got to come out.
Oh, cool.
All right, I'll talk to you later.
Okay.
Bye. Then. Bye.
WYSB. Great opening line here. I was a workshop owner in the Gulch for the People, and we got a winner here. Let's see who's on the line. Hello?
Yes, hello, Ed. This is Captain Jenks.
I thought it was you.
Yeah.
You're tricking me. Is that your real name?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, it is, Ed.
Okay, so why don't we do your real name, Captain?
You could, Captain Jenks.
If you want your prizes, you got to give your real name on the air.
This is Captain Jenks from the 36th Speed Artillery in the Republic of Dubdo.
Oh, brother. Well, we need a ruling from the judges. We have a winner here who won't give his real name on the air. All right, Captain, we'll not waste any further time. What's the name of the song here,
That's
Bill?
That's Albert Fleischer from the Guess Who.
Yeah, I thought it was you. I recognized your voice, Captain. All right, well.
You boy.
You're just a goofy listener, as Howard says, so I guess you're entitled to win.
You cool.
Right. You haven't won recently, so you haven't won before, right?
Yes, Howard Stern rules.
All right. So anyway, Captain, you're the occasion here, we go, you'd appreciate the bizarre roundabout way we chose this tune. You see, 20 years ago today, Randy Bachman left the Guess Who.
Matter of fact, he did, Ed.
Yes, and this was the first song they released after his departure, so he was not featured on this song, Albert Fleischer, so we'll see how they did after he left 20 years ago. You remember that. You were, what, 4 years old? You were paying close attention to who left the Guess Who then, right, Captain?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I was.
Yes, a pair of tickets for you to see Don Henley next Tuesday at the Spectrum. You going to tell Howard that you won?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I will.
All right, and it was fair and square, right?
Yes, that's why I didn't give you my name.
I understand. All right, pair of tickets to see the, and I won't reveal your secret identity here.
Beautiful.
Well, the judges will have to decide if you are entitled to these prizes. Pair of tickets to see Don Henley next Tuesday at the Spectrum. Also, pair of tickets for the outrageous production of O Calcutta.
Hey, Ed?
Yeah.
Do you still see Billy Joel?
Yeah, we do. Captain, you're on the verge of losing your prizes, Captain.
Oh,
you
want
to be quiet while I tell them to you?
Cool.
Yeah, okay. McDonald's Championship package consisting of 4 good any day tickets to the McDonald's Championship Golf Tournament June 4th to 10th at the DuPont Country Club in Wilmington, plus a McDonald's cap, sun visor, seat cushion, and duffel bag, and also a 12-pack of Diet Pepsi and a pair of tickets to see Steve Miller on Friday, June 22nd at the Mann Music Center, courtesy of Diet Pepsi, the right one. In recognition of National Commuter Appreciation Week, we salute your commute. All right, Captain, thanks for calling. That wasn't you calling AM Philadelphia yesterday, was it?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, it was, man.
And what did you say to Wally?
I asked if they were Howard Stern fans. As a matter of fact, I did, Ed.
I see. All right. Thank you so much. All right, we got, what do we, I don't even remember. It's Albert Fleischer, the Guess Who here from 94 WYSP.
Yes, who?
John, do loose lips sink ships?
I give up, do they?
I don't know. It's what you said.
Okay. Yes, who?
Loser.
I feel bad about it. I know John feels bad about it. But, you know, when the print press is out to get you, they'll get you.
All right. Now, I'm taking time out of my day to talk to you. I have a lot of work to do. And I'm more than willing to hear what it is that's bothering you.
Yes, how do you feel about Howard's 10.3?
Doesn't really matter to me, to tell you the truth. Hold on one moment, okay? First off, what I would do, if you want to continue the conversation, is calm down, all right? Because probably if you pick up the phone and try to even attempt this conversation with Howard Stern, he wouldn't even answer.
So why's that?
Why's that? Because he doesn't speak to the public. He doesn't give a damn.
Go on.
What's going on with the telephone?
Excuse me?
What's going on with the telephone?
What are you talking about?
Well, someone obviously picked up the telephone or did something with the telephone as I was speaking.
Is that your stance, sir?
Now, can I find out who you are? I don't know who you are. I don't even know why I'm talking to you. Now, who are you?
This is Captain Jenks.
I thought it was you.
Yes, who?
Do you swear on a stack of Bibles, John?
Pine Run, New Jersey. Hello.
May I have an explanation pertaining to the comment made about Miss Pennsylvania, Larry?
Yeah, I apologize. I was I should have said at the beginning of the show. I was on the Joan Rivers show Monday morning, and I was really tired. I was doing this book tour, and I thought the whole thing was just a sense of humor. And she asked if I thought if anyone was ugly in the contest, and I kiddingly said Miss Pennsylvania. On my vote, she finished 4th. I think she was terrific talent, and I apologize to her and her family.
Think about Howard Stern.
Yeah, what about him? What would he have to do with this? Baton Rouge, Louisiana. He says things worse than that in his sleep.
Yes, it is.
Do you think you can play some Milli Vanilli?
Milli Vanilli?
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
Why?
Can you speak up a little bit? It's really hard to hear you.
Can you play Milli Vanilli?
No.
Why?
Why would you call YSP to play Milli Vanilli?
What, you, why wouldn't you play that for me?
Settle down. We don't play Milli Vanilli.
Why?
C-L-A-S-S-I-C, rock, R-O-C-K. Milli Vanilli, if I can make a judgment, are those guys that play 90% of their concerts with pre-taped material and lip-sync to it. I don't think we play anybody like that.
I'm sorry, can you play perhaps Exposé?
No. We don't play New Kids on the Block, we don't play Milli Vanilli, we don't play Exposé.
You can't play New Kids on
the
Block?
Have you ever listened to YSP, ever, in your life? 94.1 FM. Ever?
I'm sure I have.
No, I don't think so. It's a classic rock station. None of those groups are rock. Classic we won't even get into.
Do you think that... Okay, do you think that maybe you'd be able to play...
Play what?
How about Safety Dance?
How about what? Safety Dance?
Yes.
No.
Why?
I'll tell you what. Listen to YSP for an hour and you'll know why.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Let's go right now to Sue in Germantown. Sue, you're on WCAU Talk Radio.
Hello?
Hi.
Hi. My number was given out by directory assistants because the gentleman started calling he started calling every night at the same time, and I didn't know what to do. And I'm just so afraid because he was starting to yell obscenities at me, and he says he's going to kill me.
What was it? How did he start it off? I mean, like the first time he called you, what did he say?
He called and... with...
Oh, really? Yeah, okay. That's what he said. Well, I would have hung up on him, I'll tell you. You get that sort of thing.
West Orange, New Jersey, you're next. Good evening.
Good evening. Hello, Mr. Connor. My question to you... Good God, you're bald.
Caller, do you have a guest?
What is your opinion?
Do you have a question for our guest? I'm sorry, this is a caller who we have a problem with, and I'm sorry that that happened to you, and I would appreciate that our caller would...
We're going to grab another caller. This person's from Spokane, I guess it is, isn't it? Wherever. Terry, are you with us?
Yes, hello. This is Captain Jakes from the 36th Fleet Artillery in the Federally Pippi Gip Dubdul. My question to Weird Al Yankovic is, what is your opinion of Howard Stern on YSP?
Howard Stern, he's a nutty, zany, wacky funster, ain't he?
Diplomatic, Al.
Howard's a great guy. I always feel a little nervous going on his show because he's bound to ask, anything. But it's a lot of fun.
Has he ever embarrassed you?
No. But I was heard a lot of horror stories before going on, so I was just kind of a little on edge on
the
show. Gotcha.
We've got Janet from Ohio on the line, so what do we... Hey, Janet, you with us?
Hi, this is Tim Potts, Philadelphia Magazine, calling for Captain Jenks. I'm just trying to... double-check information you gave to our reporter, Jill Feldman, on the Bella story that we're doing for our August issue. You can reach me at 545, extension 250. Should only take a...
Is what she's listening to. Terry, you're on the Rock Line with Robert Plant.
Hello, Robert, it's a thrill for me to talk to you, may I say first. May I clear something up very quickly? I'd heard a rumor that Led Zeppelin was, the name Led Zeppelin was recommended to the band by radio personality Howard Stern. Is this true?
Oh, yeah, right.
No, it was Roy Harper, actually.
Would you ever go on his show?
Stern wasn't born then.
Would you go on his show?
I had heard it was Keith Moon that came up with the name. Did you say Roy Harper? Keith Moon it was. All right, thank you, Terry.
No, he's been deciding whether he's going to have a nose job or not, all right? And this is like a big deal in his life. And yesterday I tried to call him to tell... Matt wants nothing to do with this conversation. So anyway, so I wanted to call him and tell him, your nose is fine. Don't spend the money on surgery. You're a beautiful man. Well, they hung up on me, and they weren't very nice. So I thought, let me do a little surgery myself. So let's take a look with the help of David Young. Here, first of all, is his before picture and how Howard appeared on our show. David Young, our graphic artist, and I did a little surgery on him, and this is what Howard would look like with a little nose job and a little eye tuck and all that kind of stuff. See, it's subtle. It's subtle. But I think he could use a little surgery. Now, this morning on the show, he said, I don't think I'm going to have a nose job done. Howard, and I've done a 180. I think you ought to have a little surgery. What do you think, folks? Doesn't he look better? Hello, are we alive? Do we have it? What do you think? Do you like him before or after? After? You like him? So how many want him to have a nose job? By applause.
Hey, why don't you take that and see exactly how many do?
Well, here's a fan over here. Oh, you know what happened also?
No, don't bring me into this.
All right.
Don't
what
bring
happened
me into
during
this.
The show was that Captain Jenks called. Captain Jenks is one of his regulars. You know who he is.
Yeah.
Well, he called. Stand up. What happened was he called during the show and said, hi, this is Gary with Howard Stern Show. And I said, right. No, it's not. It's Captain Jenks. They tried to fool me.
They tried to fool you.
Yeah. And so I said, I don't know why they were so nasty with me. So what do you think about Howard? Do you think he ought to get a nose job?
I don't know. He looks all right the way he is.
I think so.
You know, he's got all that hair, so the nose isn't going to make much of a difference.
Well, isn't that the truth? He should maybe put the money on hair. Remember when he dyed his hair black and then
he
hated
right.
it?
Yeah, right, he moaned about that for
yeah.
how long, right?
Well, Howard's got problems, doesn't he?
A few.
Okay.
But he's got the money to take care of it,
yeah,
so.
Who cares, right? All right, thank you very much. Thank you for your opinions. All right, should we move on?
I think this
okay.
is a huge
yes, Peter
mistake.
Said. See, Matt is such a big baby. He
no,
doesn't
it's not.
Want... Well,
not
he doesn't,
a big
no,
baby.
Not a big baby. He doesn't want to get involved with Howard because he says it's a battle that you can't lose. And
you
I
can't win. No,
you.
It's a battle that you can't. I just don't. I just want it to be said
whatever
I was
Howard
absent
wants,
on this day, okay?
Matt wants him to have.
Hello?
Hi, it's Ken home.
Just a moment.
Thank you. Oh, Ken.
Yeah, this is Ken.
How you doing, man? My name's Kevin.
Yeah.
How you doing, dude?
Hi.
Hey, you were the guy on the air the other day, right?
Yeah.
No, that's cool. Listen, I'm doing an article, and I want to ask you a few questions. You think you'll give me a minute of your time?
Yeah, I'd like to do it.
Are you, like, are you eating or something? Am I bothering you?
No, you're not bothering me.
All right, cool. All right, so then why don't you give me 5 minutes? By the way, you listen to Howard's show all the time?
Yeah, I do.
All right, you ever hear of Captain Jenks?
No, I'm not familiar with that.
Okay. Just wanted to ask you about that. He's on the line also. All right, listen. Hey, give me the correct spelling of your name, would you? Because I want to make sure I print it right.
Okay.
Is it really Kenneth Keith?
Yeah, it's K-E-N-N.
K-E-N-E-T-H.
No, it's K-E-N-N.
N-N-E-T-H.
And then my middle name is Keith. K-E-I-T-H.
Right, and spell your last name for me.
Okay. K-A-L-L-E-N-D-A-C-H.
Okay, cool. Hey, are you aware that your initials are KKK?
Yes, I'm aware of that.
What do you think about that, man?
Well...
I mean, is that a fluke, or is that something that just happened, or is that, like, something your parents planned?
No, they didn't plan it. My mom liked the name. It had nothing to do with,
Right, because...
She just liked the name. It just happened to be that. It was KKK. It just happened to be that way.
Cool. How old are you, dude?
21,
cool. Do you have, like, if you could, like, sum up in a phrase your experience, like, of doing that? You know, in other words, if you could give me, like, a one-sentence, like, feeling about, you know, being on the TV show... what could you tell me, you know? Did you have a real good time, or was it great? Is it something you want to do again? You know, is there anything you want to say?
I think the saying would be, destiny had it that I would beat Howard Stern and be on a TV show.
Okay, I'm just writing this down. Okay, and, are you going to retry this? Is he going to give you another chance to do it, or what?
I don't know. I don't know if he's going to call me back or not.
Okay, so basically what we saw on TV that night was that you never did it. You claimed to have done it backstage with Jessica Hahn, that she saw it. That's what you claimed on the air, that she saw you do it once. But
I claimed that I threw air out my eye, not smoke, but air.
Okay, but air, and okay, so no smoke came out. And you don't, I know on the air you said that you don't remember the first time, but you have no idea how old you were when you first did it?
No, I don't have any idea.
Okay, that's cool. All right, well, I guess that's about it. Why don't you give me your address so I can mail you a copy of this if you want. All right. To your name, and that your address is, yeah.
W-Y-N-P-A.
And what's the zip, dude?
It's 19061.
Okay, cool. All right, once I publish it, I'll send you a copy of it, just so you can...
Yeah, I'd really like answering questions and all that. If you have any more questions, call me back.
Yeah, no problem, dude. I just, this is just basically for the whole review of the show. I just wanted to get the facts correct. They didn't provide your name or anything like that.
Have you ever met Howard personally?
Yeah, I have. I met him at the Grammys in Los Angeles. And, in the Philly funeral, you know, when he buried DiBella? I was there at the press conference. I videotaped it, and I was part of that little scene, so it was pretty cool.
Well, if you ever get a chance to talk to him or something, tell him that I want to invite him over to my house.
Cabbage? You want to do, cook him dinner or something?
Invite him over to my house for, a barbecue.
That's cool. Hey, did you go to the rally? Did you go to that rally when he buried DiBella?
I was working, but I was I was in the vicinity. I was real close.
Good.
Hey, one other thing. I'll send you along a form if you want. I make this newsletter on Howard's show.
Yeah.
And I put it out, so if you're interested in it, I'll send some information, too.
Yeah, send everything you got.
All right, dude. And if I come up with anything, I'll give you a call back.
All right, that sounds cool.
Is it okay?
Yeah, it's cool.
All right, good, man. Then I'll talk to you later, pal.
All right,
see you later. Bye-bye. Tom.
Let's talk with Bill in North Wales. Hello, Bill.
Oh, no. I don't want to do that at all. And, I really don't like talking to you because,
Goodbye. Then you don't want to know what the hell he's talking about. Do you have any idea what he was talking about, Mook? Let's talk with Don.
This guy great.
Mrs. White, does Larry smell? Pardon?
I don't know, but how anyone could try to make a humorous kind of call over a situation like this would tell us a lot about choices in this country of why certain people live and certain people don't.
West Orange, New Jersey. Hello.
Ellie, do you like Larry or Howard Stern better?
Oh, Larry. And, I lived in West Orange, New Jersey. For 1 year, I went to West Orange High School, I think it was the year Mickey Mantle won the Triple Crown, but no compare. Larry is, and I come from the same place, Howard Stern, I have to put up with.
Well, by the way, you mentioned before that you were rooting for the Red Sox. Are you a Yankee fan who just happens to be rooting for the Red Sox this year, or are you a Red Sox fan?
I like the Red Sox because the people seem to expect so much and not been gratified for so long. So actually, the Howard Stern show had a very funny moment where one of his interviewers was sitting next to Ted Williams and asked Ted Williams if he ever passed wind. They put it another way in a catcher's face, and Ted Williams was so funny. He was signing autographs. I like the Red Sox, and especially since I now know who Ellis Kinder was, and from that great book, The Summer of 49.
Jenkintown, Pennsylvania, for Jesse Jackson. Hello.
Reverend Jackson, what do you think of Howard Stern, and have you ever hurt yourself going, ow?
Okay, Long Island, New York. Hello.
Yonkers, New York. Go ahead.
Good morning. The National Organization for Women was joined in its opposition of Souter by the Fund for the Feminist Majority, the National Lawyers, and the National Gay and Lesbian Task Force. My question is, does Judge Souter base any of his decisions on what his mommy says?
Well, we don't know really the basis for Judge Souter's decisions. He hasn't written a lot of decisions in New Hampshire based on federal constitutional issues, so we don't know exactly on what he is basing his decision. He is obviously a smart man. He was a Rhodes Scholar. He went to Harvard Law School. He's a very voracious reader and erudite man, so there's no question that he is intelligent, what his personal views are on some of these matters. I'm not sure whether we're going to learn today. Planned Parenthood put out a survey the other day that a private firm that they had commissioned took, and the public believes, according to this survey, or 49% of the public believes that the nominee's personal views on issues like privacy, religion, abortion, and civil rights should be a major factor in his confirmation. Whether Judge Souter will give us his personal views as distinct from his legal views, I don't know. But in essence, we don't know what those views are.
Up to Montgomery, Pennsylvania. You're next.
Yes, sir. I was wondering your personal opinion of radio personality Howard Stern.
I'm not sure that's a really relevant question. You want to know about if you knew Howard Stern. I think that's, I think we'll pass over that one.
Yeah.
Yes, Zoom.
Hi, John. Didn't the new ratings just come out today?
No.
How'd you do?
If they didn't come out, how would I know?
They did come out. Andy Bloom said they came out.
Yes, yeah, Zoom.
You're a homo and your show sucks.
But only you would know that.
Yes, I would. Goodbye, sweetheart.